Hello everyone! Welcome back to another 2v2 battle. Grimgore is pissed. This is going to be two green skin armies versus two beastman armies. We have, for my army, two goblins, two night goblins, three goblin archers. We have two goblin big bosses on spiders with a couple of healing potions. We have two black orcs, an arachnorok, a orc biggin, and a orc shaman in the middle. Off in vanguard deployment, I have a total of three goblin wolf riders, two over here and one on the other side of the map. And we ended up Vanguard deploying right on top of each other, right in this group of Chaos Puppies. Mm-hmm. So part of the Beastman army is in Vanguard deployment. We have Chaos Warhounds, two Centaurs with great weapons. We have three Gore Herds, three Ungore Herds, and then three Ungore Raiders. Over here we have more Gore Herds, a Cygore, a Bray Shaman, and Kazarak the One-Eye. Over here we have another Shaman. Let's see, I think two more actually. Yeah, two more Shamans over here, four Minotaurs, just the normal ones. A generic Beast Lord, a line of Gore Herds, two Razor Gores. There's my other Goblin Wolf Rider. And my ally brought two Wolf Rider Archers, two normal Goblin Archers right there, three Night Goblin Fanatics. We have three Orc Savages, two more Black Orcs, a Night Goblin Shaman, a generic Orc War Boss, Goblin Forest Spider Riders, and two of those. And then three Orc Boar Boys? Yeah, three Orc Boar Boys. Whew, and so this is the first time. Also, I think this is a new map, right? Golden Monolith, that's a new map? I don't know, I don't remember, I don't recognize it. I think it's a new map. So I've never Vanguard deployed right on top of somebody. This is a first. And Goblin Wolf Riders aren't exactly the highest of leadership, so they actually break pretty quick. They break pretty quick. And I'm trying to save my other Goblin Wolf Riders. I'm gonna be sending them back towards our army. While these poor goblins are instantly routed off the field. An entire unit, because I Vanguard deployed right on the enemy, is gone. So that was a good opening to this battle. The two Goblin Wolf Rider archers are going up because the enemy has no real response to this other than these Razor Gores, but they can outrun them. So that's a good move with those. Yeah. The Razor Gores, I believe, have 50 armor, so the Goblin Archers don't do too much, but they'll still do something. So my idea over here, as we're about to get charged with these Wolf Riders, I'm trying to pull them back, is that I'm going to devote some of our forces to try and hold off these Vanguard forces. Oh, actually, we get a charge up here. I forgot about this. We're going to try and send some Black Orcs over here as well. But yeah, I want to just send a couple forces over here and then some other forces to deal with this main Beastman force over on this side, is the idea. Currently, these Black Orcs are surrounded by Centaurs with great weapons. But we're getting our Ragnarok in there, so it's going to scare them off. Black Orcs took a little bit of damage there. We also had our Goblin Big Boss over there. There goes that Vanguard force coming in. Razor Gore's getting to these Night Goblins. And they're getting the heck out of there. Weedawa. So yeah, this Vanguard deployed army is making me kind of take a more defensive posture on the left flank, so I don't want them to just kind of run in and take out the back line of my ally. Cygore going for the Arachnorok Spider and missing that shot, luckily. I'll probably show this one in two different battles, because there are going to be two different fights, engagements that are going to happen. You see I'm pulling my forces back away from here. Here come the Minotaurs. Minotaurs, huh? But we will get back to this fight later. Arachnorok leading the way. As we're about to get flanked by some gores. I'm okay with the Arachnorok soaking up all this Ungore fire, because that's such a high armor that their damage isn't really going to do too much. So that's why I sent it in first. We also have our goblin big bosses in the battle here. Getting our one goblin wolf rider that's remaining that was over here on the side of the field over close to us. Now we're just trying to bury our Ragnarok as deep in the lines as possible and just start munching on people. Our black orcs slowly marching in with Grimgore. We have goblin archer support over here as well. Then I'm going to have to divert some forces to try and deal with these razor gores that are charging to our archers. So our black orcs get in there. Trying to save my goblin archers as much as possible, and I'm currently running from the Centaurs and the puppies. Meanwhile, the goblin big bosses and the Arachnarok are kind of holding off this entire vanguard force by themselves. Now, these Arachnarok, or spider-riding goblin bosses are just duelists, so they don't really have the AoE damage of other mounted heroes. My goblin wolf fighters do get caught by this group, so they are going to rout as well. But Grimgore and his immortals are going to be able to turn back the Razorgore herd over here. Actually, that's the shaman. Where is Grimgore? Where is Grimgore? Oh, he's over here. Sorry, he's over here with the Orc Biggins. Fighting against the Minotaurs currently. Woo! Yeah, you don't fight Grimgore, Minotaurs. Jeez, that's two down. Can we get a three? Oh, it's gonna run. My goblin archers are now free to rain death upon these Ungor Raiders, Gorhers, just this giant clump of forces while we flank them with our Black Orcs. Ragnarok still holding strong against now a Saigor as well. Our goblin big boss is still out and about. You can see it is taking some damage though. But it's also distracting a lot of units. As are these goblin big bosses. Just normal gores don't have much of a chance against a group of black orcs. Spray Shaman trying to do what it can against a group of black orcs. That's a tough fight for it, especially with the goblin archer support. And now we're trying to wait away from these gores and intercept them with the orc biggins. Again, we need to protect our goblin archers. They have not used nearly enough ammunition for them to be worth it at this point if they die. So the Orc Biggin's going to do pretty good against these Gore Herds. Led by Grimgore. Meanwhile, the two Black Orcs are starting to be whittled away. Especially this group fighting against their Beast Lord. Or Kazarak, specifically. And their Brave Shaman. And here comes another Beast Lord. And a Manticore being summoned in the background from their Shaman. Arachnarok still in the fight. It's taken a lot of damage, but is now just taking it on this Saigor with the help of the Goblin Big Boss. So the reason why I put the Big Boss here is because on a spider, his attacks are poisoned, so that's going to be lowering the Saigor's stats. Oh my. Oh, I'm just a big dumb Saigor. Oh. Anyway. So that's why the Goblin Big Boss is over here assisting the Arachnarok, is just to keep this unit poisoned. This group of Black Orcs doing really well against the Gore Herds and Ungor Raiders, as to be expected. These group of Black Orcs still doing what they can against these leaders. Kazarak is pretty tough, though. But they're going to get Orc Biggin support, and... Where is Grimgore? There you are. He's right there. So now we got him against Kazarak. And you can see, Grimgore has not even been touched. Because he is a monster. My Ragnarok over here finally routs from fighting with the Saigor, and the Manticore is currently chasing. One of my goblin big bosses was hounding some of the units back here, and I believe we'll continue to attack the Saigor now. The other goblin big boss... I don't think they're dead. It's right there. There they are. There they are. Helping Grimgore. Orc Biggins being shattered by the broken. Sorry, not goblins, not Biggins. Being broken by this Manticore. Trying to get some arrows into it because it is lower armor. Orc Pagans also have a bonus versus large, so this is going to be pretty good for them. Goblin Big Boss almost being able to take down the Saigor. Just taking out its ankles, I guess. It's Achilles' heel. It's kind of a funny sight. Here comes the other one. Yeah! 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 That Goblin Big Boss is... Oh god, it's feeling pretty good, but you gotta go, man. There they go, they're gonna charge in. And you can see we have wrapped up most of the units. We still do have some resistance there with all of their Brace Shamans and their Saigor. I threw in our Night Goblins into the path of these Centaurs so then we can pin them down and shoot them up with the Goblin Archers. That was the idea. We also have some goblins that came back from routing over here. And there come the Arch of Fire. Centaurs are not very heavily armored, so the Goblin Archers are going to do pretty well against them, as long with these puppies. And you see the Manticore fighting for its life back there. Actually, it's routing a couple of Goblin Wolfriders. Shatter them, even. Oh, wow. And we're going to push off those Centaurs that came up behind us, and currently we are charging up here to deal with the remaining Beastmen on the hill. Go for its ankles. It's weak in the ankles. The Saigor does do armor piercing, so it's probably going to do a lot of damage to these Black Orcs. It has a lot of damage to deal. Manticore is over here as well, trying to assist their Khazrak and the Beast Lord. Actually, I don't even know if Khazrak's still alive, but it's over here to assist the Beast Lord. And then their army is going to shatter. And that's going to be a victory. Let me load this up and we're going to watch how my ally dealt with all of those Minotaurs. Because that was a lot. Get them, Orc boys. Those Razor Gores just look really cool. Yeah, Fnatic. Get in there. Oh, God. He just killed himself. There goes that charge of the Minotaurs. Yeah, 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 get in there, get in there. Yeah. I rarely ever see those Fnatics do much, but they still just look cool. Charge them. Got like 15 goblins per Minotaur. Curse of the Big Bad Moon going down. Doesn't look like it's gonna hit too many. Minotaurs breaking through the front line, getting into the Savage Orcs behind. And we got Black Orcs coming in to support. Again, the Minotaurs are very low armor, but they also deal a lot of damage. They are so tough. But if you can focus them down with a bunch of arrow fire, that's a good way to deal with them. Here comes some Orc boys out of the forest. Managing to push the Minotaurs that round a little bit. Let's take a bird's eye view of what's going on. A lot of routing from our goblins, but that's to be expected. They'll come back. They'll be back. But we still got a lot solid line of Savage Orcs and Black Orcs backed up with these Orc boys. You can just hear all that arch of fire from the Goblin Wolf Riders and the Goblin Archers that my ally had. And it's really taking a toll on these Minotaurs. That's how they dealt with them here. We also have a Itchy Noosis going down to lower their melee attack and weapon damage, which is not going to help them at all. And so many arrows. Just a thousand tiny needles. Over there, Grimgor was taking care of those Minotaurs that we saw earlier. Here comes some Centaurs in that Chaos puppy group. Looks like they were dealing with some more goblins that routed back here. And they're going to get into those goblin archers. A good call. An Ancient Noose is being dropped on them as well. The Goblin Shaman going to do what he can against these Centaurs and the puppies. But the front line of the beasts have already been basically dealt with. The Goblin Archers and the Wolf Rider Archers were able to deal a lot of damage to those Minotaurs, and they were able to break them. So it was a good move to get these Centaurs in here in the back line, but it took a little too long. Run, Gobbos! Here we got some Forest Goblin Riders in the back. Hitting them with some poison damage. And you can see they are getting surrounded. So this enemy relied heavily on the Minotaurs, but with their low armor and all of the ranged damage that my ally had, not to mention, I mean, Savage Orcs have a high attack, so they're going to get their weapon damage through, and I mean, Black Orcs. They had a lot of damage to deal with, and even the Minotaurs couldn't keep up with, or take it all. And with the Minotaurs breaking, the Gorherd didn't have much of a chance either, so they broke as well. And so this enemy was kind of wrapped up pretty quickly. I don't think there's really much else to show from my ally's perspective. They're just going to be heading up towards me. We do have a Minotaur group coming back from routing, but they're not going to do too much. Neither is this Gore Herd. So let's go to the kill screen. See how the armies did. Here we go. So Grimgor, 33 kills. My Shaman got 125. Holy crap. I did bring the Brain Buster spell. I brought the Here We Go spell, which is the 58 increased attack damage. So I did use the Brain Buster a couple times, and he was also in melee. I didn't realize he got so many kills. The Goblin Big Bosses both got a ton of kills, especially considering they are duelists. Again, which that means they don't do the area effect damage. They're mostly suited just for one-on-one combat. That's a lot of kills. The Night Goblins didn't do too much, but that's okay. Orc Biggins, 84 kills. Black Orcs, 238. This one only got 61. I think this was the one that was fighting against the Kazrek, the One-Eye, his Bray Shaman, and what else is there? A couple Gore Herds. They may have been also getting shot by Slagwars, I'm not too sure. Goblin Archers, in fact, got a respectable amount of kills. Where's the third one? There we go. So, above 20 each on a Goblin. That's fine. My poor Goblin Wolf Riders, though, they did not shine in this battle. Arachnarok, 191 kills is really good, and these goblins kind of, they did all right. For Gunnar here, the Beastlord, 19 kills. Shamans didn't get much, but they were probably just maybe buffing and debuffing. Goreherds got a respectable amount of kills. Razorgore, same thing. Minotaurs, even though they were getting focused out so much, they still get so many kills. A lot of those are probably against Night Goblins, though, and Savage Orcs, but still, a lot of kills. For the other enemy, Kazrak got 31 kills. Most of that was probably against my group of Black Orcs because he was fighting them for a long time. Ungore Herds didn't do too much. The normal Gore Herds, though, did really well. A really respectable amount of kills there. The Ungore Raiders did okay. These Centaurs just wrecked my Goblin Wolf Riders, which is probably where they got most of their kills. Also, those Goblin Archers. Same thing with the puppies. Cygor netting, 4 kills. For my ally, the green skin player, the Orc War Boss, I don't think really saw much combat. The Shaman got 16. Night Goblin Frontline got kind of destroyed by the Minotaurs and then the Centaurs later on. The Savage Orcs, I think, did really well. Black Orcs did pretty well. Same thing with the Goblins. Overall, pretty good. One of these Orc Boys got shut down. I really want to see... We're never going to get these stats, but I want to see how much damage was negated from poison. From a unit being affected by poison, how much damage was negated, and how many hits did not connect because of poison. I want to see these stats so I know exactly how effective the poison damage is, because between the two of us, we had so many Night Goblins. These two Forest Spider Riders are also poisoned. My Goblin Big Bosses were poisoned. These Night Goblins were poisoned. So, Arachnarok, we have a ton of poison damage. I really want these very deep stats, you know? I want to see how good everything is. but we're never gonna see it, and it is upsetting. But overall, I thought it was a fun game, a little Greenskin versus Beastman. I hope you enjoyed that one, and I will see you all next time. Again, leave your suggestions below on what armies you'd like to see. Have a good day.